going through that now with my sister in LA, who's still very, very ill. And I'm angry with her because it's like you know, none of this is real. You can create, you can control your situation, you can whatever you believe. And she always chooses to believe, in my mind, the most negative things, you know, that people are always mean and always out to take advantage of her, and that she's destined to just waste away to nothing and die. And so she chooses to do nothing and just waste away. And it's very frustrating for me because I know I don't have control, and I know whatever's meant to be will be, but it's really hard to sit by and watch. And I find myself being very unreasonably angry with her over that. And it's funny because I'm fairly non-judgmental with everybody, but I walk in the room with her and it's like, bam, you know.
That would just be a transfer training thing to look at, in the sense that we talked earlier about how, remember, decision is in the mind. So we could say the mind seems to make a purpose decision. A split mind, we'll say, seems to make a choice between ego and Holy Spirit. We've heard that. The Course teaches that, and so forth. And then remember I said, where Jesus said, do not project the error to time. So what's happening there, if you go into the mind and this unwinding, you'll start to see that if it's always a purpose, it's a decision of mind, it's a choice of mind, and I'm perceiving a sister out there, a person who believes in illness or believes and so forth, then that very construct is attempting to project the error to time. The split is in the mind and can only be healed when it's seen in the mind. And the ego is ingenious at inventing everything, including a sister or a person who believes. It could flip the other way around. It could be, I'm a person who believes this, she's a person who believes that, and just the anger. But the projection, as long as the mind is forgotten that it's dreaming, and it sees that persons have beliefs, persons have thoughts, persons have decision-making capability. Isn't that what this whole thing seems to be? Mm-hmm. It would be almost like going to a movie and getting upset at the characters in the movie for the emotions that they were expressing.
Which I have been known to do.
And that's like another version of it. That's just another version of it. Or I use the example sometime like someone going to a movie and like Terms of Endearment or something, a pretty famous movie, and coming home and just crying and bawling and bawling. And, what's wrong? Was it a sad movie? Oh yes, it was sad. It's like, you know, what's wrong? Deborah Winger, she died. She died. What do you mean she died? Yeah, she's dead. I saw it. I just watched it. You know. Shirley MacLaine was there, and Deborah Winger died. You know. And then it's like, no, she's just an actress.
Still being Hollywood.
Yeah, she's just pretending, you know. This and this. And, but the whole thing is taking the act to be the real thing. And that is a good metaphor for the mind taking the act to be the real thing. You know, forgetting it's just a, you know, it's a shadows, just images.
That's helpful because I'm having a lot of trouble with this issue. And it's been ongoing for a while. I mentioned it last time.
Yeah.